Future Talk Radio, your in to all things music.
Welcome to Jackie's Groove. Come journey with us through the rhythm of the music business with your host, Jackie Bertone.
Everybody, welcome to Jackie's Groove. This is Jackie Bertone, brought to you by InterTalk Radio Network, connection to all things music. Guys, it's a wonderful, wonderful November the 3rd, Friday, and kind of get a little bit out of my wheelhouse here, but I'm back in my lane because the gentleman that's going to be on my show today that's in my studio is someone that started out with me when I first started out on this station, almost going on 2 years this January. And since that time, he is now a radio mate, for the lack of a better word. You can catch his show on intertalkradio.com/makingit. And that is his tagline for his show. I am proud and I'm privileged, as I always say, to bring my musical brother into the studio. It's actually going to be a dual interview, and we're going to be promoting his new show coming up November the 11th. So with that said, guys, welcome with open ears and open ears to Jackie's Groove. Please welcome Mr. Terry Wollman. Terry, welcome, brother.
Thank you, Jackie. Great to be on your show, back on your show again.
Yeah,
and,
man.
And have an opportunity for both of us to chat.
Let's talk about what we're doing here. Other than, you know, talking to the people out there, let's talk on what's coming up here on November the 11th for your show. And in fact, the read that was on the release really didn't show more of music than more of eating. And so, Terry, I'm going to step back. I'm going to let you tell the audience out there exactly what you're doing on November the 11th.
Well, I'm performing with my band at a beautiful new music venue called Back Bay Bistro in Newport Beach. And it's been around for a while, but there's new management, and they're bringing live music paired with interesting meals that go along with each artist that's there. So because I'm from Miami, we are doing a Miami Spice point of view on the menu. Mm-hmm. But so it's a combination of food that has influenced me from Caribbean to South Florida, South Beach, but also, you know, my music and my band. And it's going to be a really fun night. The food's fantastic there. It's a great venue. It's right on the water. And I'm bringing my quartet down there, as well as having a special guest vocalist, Melanie Taylor, who's happens to be in town from touring.
Finally. Right now.
Yeah, finally. So it's kind of a fun pairing, you know, when, you know, there's really something special, I think, about combining music and food and wine.
Absolutely.
You know, adult beverages. Some of our adult beverages are going to be a mango infused martini, because my production company is Mango Eater Music, and I grew up picking mangoes in Florida. So, but the other third element of the evening is that it's right on the water. It's literally this restaurant, this beautiful restaurant, has a full view of the bay. There's a marina. People can come in from their boat and dock and come on in and join us and have dinner or drive up. And I've always loved playing on the water because it reminds me of Florida.
Yeah. You know, and Terry, I want to jump in here real quick too. I don't want anybody out there thinking, because Terry just drew this amazing picture of this beautiful venue, it is very reasonable for everything that you're getting. There's going to be different tiers that you can purchase on this VIP all the way down to general admission. But I'll tell you, after we did my first show with Bunny Burnell earlier this month, in which Terry graced me, surprised me, actually. Yeah, it was definitely, definitely wonderful. The menu was from Bunny, but you were still able to buy and purchase off of Back Bay Bistro's menu.
Right.
Again, why would you? I don't know. Just because the food there, the specialties are wonderful. But again, I agree with Terry. It is so romantic, and it's a very sexy, sexy venue. And the sound, Terry, would you agree that was, after working a few bugs out, it sounded pretty good in that room?
Yeah, it's a great sounding room, and I think it's got the potential to be one of the up and coming rooms in Southern California. And we certainly need more places for live music that are musician friendly, but also fan friendly. And this again is the kind of place where you can just come in, sit at the bar, and have a drink or two, and just enjoy the music. You don't need to buy dinner, but dinner is going to be amazing, and the chef there is wonderful. But you can also, like you said, you can order a hamburger off the menu if that's what you want to do, and or you know, have the full experience or the partial experience. Everybody's in the same room. You're not going to be excluded if you walk in and sit at the bar. And actually, it sounds really good at the bar because I walked the room during the last show just to see how it sounded everywhere, and it was comfortable and fun. Great sight lines, so you know, there's no poles in the way or you know, blocked views anywhere. So please come and join us. It's going to be a great night. But I think it's also really important to support live music venues. They're making it easy to do that by not making it expensive. It's very affordable to come on out.
So would it be fair to say that this gets the two thumbs up, the Terry Wollman seal of approval?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I'm actually really looking forward to performing there.
Okay, so we're going to come back to that, Terry, but I do want to take the time with you because Caprice and I were... happened to see a repeat of if your name's not in the obituary, you know, correct me in the title.
Yeah, if you're not in the obit, eat breakfast.
Yeah, and it is probably the most enlightening show, if you will, on HBO. And what it was is that at the end, if you have a heart, I would suggest to the right or left of you is actually have a box of Kleenex to see these luminaries in this industry. You know, the Dick Van Dykes, which we all grew up with, and just to see how viable these gentlemen are in. Terry, do me a favor. Can you draw another picture, if you will, about the whole vibe of this show and what it entails?
Absolutely. It's a documentary, but I call it a documentary about happiness, which is needed and kind of rare because most documentaries are about very important things in the world that need our attention. And they're generally things that have sadness to it, you know, and this is for a change, a documentary about people that are in their 90s and hundreds, many celebrities, not everybody in the movie is a celebrity. So it's a really nice mix of just regular folk and then people who have had success and notoriety that are living full, active, fun, vital lives, doing really interesting things with the last, you know, chapter of their lives. And they they're doing amazing things, you know, from, you know, a 98-year-old woman who's a track star. You know, she runs track and she's a world record holder.
Crazy.
Or a 100-year-old yogi. Or there's just some beautiful, beautiful people in this movie. I had the honor of producing three music segments for the movie. And one was with Tony Bennett. We flew to New York and produced Tony with his quartet,
so
then came back to Los Angeles and worked with Dick Van Dyke. I took him in the studio and wrote an arrangement and produced that. And he came in and sang a duet with his wife, and it's beautiful. And by the way, there's two versions that we just released on iTunes. I'm not sure if I had told you that yet, Jackie, but
no.
There's a bonus version of Dick's version singing by himself. And then there's the version from the movie with the duet with his wife. And they're both wonderful. You can check them out on iTunes. We also had the opportunity to go back in the studio a third time at Capitol Records in Los Angeles with Alan Bergman. Alan and Marilyn Bergman wrote a beautiful song called Just Getting Started with Dave Grusin. And we recorded that. Dave Grusin wrote that arrangement and I produced it and we went in and cut that. So all three of those icons are in the soundtrack for the movie, but also on camera. You get to see them perform and do what really brings them joy and keeps them young. And it was a really special experience for me.
Yeah. And you know, I want to jump in also too, Terry. I want the listeners out there to understand that just even though this is my show today, I want everybody to redirect themselves to InterTalkRadio.com/making it and just mention about Bergman. You've got to hear this amazing interview that Terry did, sat down with these two geniuses when it comes to music. It was heartwarming. It was touching. And that's the beauty of our network is you can, if you can't listen to us live, It's there. It's etched in stone, so you can go back and listen to it. And I highly recommend it because you're talking about history from right. people who make history. And, you know, Terry, this one thing I'm really, really proud about in this network itself with making it and with Jackie's Groove is that just, again, celebrating the elders in the industry itself. And I started this all out by interviewing Walfredo Reyes Sr. Mm-hmm. I was approached by Wally Jr. and Danny Reyes, and they said, would you mind and considered interviewing my dad? And I said, it would be an honor. And he said, because Wally says, when dad goes, so go the stories. And and then the follow-up that with Peter Michael and Sheila E. Wanting to do a interview with Pete Escobedo Sr., or Pops, as they call him. So we're paying homage to that. We're trying to get everybody connected. As I always say this, and I say this, and I'm steadfast, to know where music is going, we have to know where it started. And
it's important to to look from where we came.
You know what I'm blown out, though, Terry, that, you know, as long as, you know, you and I, believe it or not, we've known each other since 1990. That's how old you and I are.
Yeah.
And but to know that I interviewed you, you accepted my invitation, mm-hmm. and then to fast forward 5 months after that, you had your own show. When I came to you and told you the CEO was interested in that, you kind of did a two-step, like, really? And I put you guys in contact, and as they say, the rest is history. Are you having a great time? Because your interviews show that you are.
Yeah, I absolutely am. I find it very challenging, and I also find it very stimulating because I really use this as an opportunity to shine the light, not just on the elders. I mean, I've had some young folks on as well, and I like to mix it up right. with current younger artists, up-and-coming artists. Mm-hmm. But the most special part, I think, for me is to tell the stories of the people that are the giants that are in the mm-hmm. music industry, because we have a lot to learn from them, and they have a lot to share. You know, there's a mentoring aspect or quality that most people that have had a successful career include in their lives. You know, they want to give back information because that's how they got to where they were. People Absolutely. Reached out and put their hands on their shoulders and taught them how to maneuver through music and being an artist and the business and all aspects of it. You know, they've been mentored. So the answer is yes. I actually really am enjoying it. I'm finding the freedom that you and I are both allowed in our shows to bring in any guests that we want in an unedited format.
Absolutely.
Is really stimulating for me. And what I do is, even if I know the artist, and that's kind of sort of the premise of my show, I interview people that I know.
Sure.
Many of them happen to be celebrities, but they're people that I already have a relationship with. Mm-hmm. So I know a lot about them, but I use it as an opportunity to ask things that I am curious about, but also ask questions about things that I already know the answer to that I think sure. would be important to share with our listeners. And I think that you do the same, Jackie. Isn't that true?
Yeah, you know, and it's like I just said, I'll reiterate what Terry said. I mean, these people that I'm interviewing, friends of mine, fellow musicians that Terry has known even longer than I have, I know the response, I know the answers, but I'm still blown away by a lot of things that I didn't know. The stuff that you can't read about in Modern Drummer magazine or Guitar Player magazine. So it becomes very, very informative to myself. I catch myself going, really? You know, right. just blown away because you think that since you are so thick in the industry that you know everything about it, but my God, you don't.
Right.
And there's something I'm going to tell you right ahead of time, Terry. I am going to steal your idea, and I'm going to find out whose idea was it to flip the script, for the lack of a better word, because Terry's very dear friends and has also produced a beautiful woman by the name of Melissa Manchester.
Yes.
And a song that actually was like the soundtrack. My mother used to love the song, and that song was called Don't Cry Out Loud.
Yeah.
And, you know, and that song has always been her mainstay. Whose idea was it to have her interview you? And is it okay if I steal that idea and have somebody that I have in mind that I want to do the same thing back? Go ahead and share with us.
Absolutely. Actually, we did that for the 1 year anniversary of me hosting my show right. on InterTalk Radio. And it was Melissa's idea, actually. She came to me at one point and said, you know, I'd really like to interview you sometime on your show. Would you be open to that? And I said, that's fantastic. I love the idea. And I said, why don't we save that for a special occasion? And the natural occasion that we chose was the 1 year anniversary of doing shows. And it was a really interesting experience for me and very revealing, you know, because Melissa and I know each other well, and she asked some questions and I actually talked about some things that I've actually have not spoken about publicly before. Mm-hmm. But it seemed very natural because Melissa did the same thing as we do. She gave it a lot of thought and asked me some very, insightful questions.
Yeah. The first thing I thought to Tino, Florentino was, do we offer her her own show? Because can you imagine the ratings that would draw in, you know, and it's, but the fact of the matter is, even though these people are superstars, they're still people, you know, I'm still starstruck to this day. I'm still starstruck. You know, when I hang out with you, Terry, I mean, this is the background that you have. Mm-hmm. I pinch myself at times because it blows me out of the water that I grew up with said musician's music. And then I find myself years later, either recording with that artist or being on stage with that artist. It still kind of boggles my mind. But obviously, mm-hmm. our talents bring us to that situation. It's not that who you know and so on, because the people that we're associated with, I don't care if you're their family. If you don't play and then play right, you're not going to be welcome to that stage or on a recording.
Right.
And I want to ask this question, and can you believe it's blowing by again? This is 1 minute and 30 seconds left.
Sure.
But I want to talk to you about, I didn't ask this question when we did our first interview, but I want to talk about everything that you've been blessed with musically, either as a sideman or as the lead, like my favorite album, The Silver Collection. Mm-hmm. I want to talk more about that also. But I want to find out, does Terry Wollman have a bucket list? Or have you already reached that? Is that bucket list overflowing, or are you still emptying it out and we're hoping to refill it? And
we are scratching the surface.
yeah, exactly. From your lips to God's ears. I mean,
yeah.
You and I, you know, we're not whippersnappers, but you know, we've got a lot of vitality left in us.
Yeah.
And so, you know, put your thinking cap on there, because I do want to ask you some questions about that. Then I want you to flip the script on me and ask me the situation. Hopefully
absolutely,
I'll give you the right answer.
So, and we also want to remind everybody that one of the things we're talking about today is my upcoming Terry Wollman band performance at Back Bay mm-hmm. Bistro in Newport Beach. And you can find it on my Facebook page. You can find it on Intertalk Radio's page. And you can just go to Back Bay Bistro and get yourself there. If you do, come say hi. Jackie and I are both going to be there. Obviously, I will because I'm performing.
Sure. And that's NewportDunes.com. Also, you want to reach out to them and TicketWeb.com.
That's
and get your tickets ahead of time, because we don't want to put you in a situation where it was packed to the hilt last time, and I'm sure it's going to be that way this time also. So with that said, stepping out of segment number one into segment number two with my in-studio guest, my radio mate, Mr. Terry Wollman. I'm Jackie Bertone, Jackie's Groove, brought to you by the Talk Radio Network. Guys, don't go anywhere. I'll be right back after these short words.
See you in a minute.
Are you serious about your music? Are you ready to run with the big dogs? The experts at Pitbull Audio have the gear to get you into the game. From leading manufacturers like Mesa Boogie, Fender, Pioneer, and American Audio, to sound your best, you need the best. Pitbull Audio can deliver in rehearsal, on stage, and into the big time. Dropping beats, shredding guitar, or making the crowd roar. Whatever you dream, Pitbull Audio can help make it happen. We are Pitbull Audio. We want you to play it loud. PitbullAudio.com.
You know what's all around you every waking moment of your life? Marketing. You're choking on it. I'm Scott Robertson, and when it comes to strategic PR, branding, and marketing, I've seen it all. And actually, I'm still seeing it, because bad marketing never sleeps. Join me each week on May the Best Brand Win, right here on InnerTalk Radio, and learn how to make the marketing for your brand unforgettable.
Hi, I'm Tim Dolbear, the host of Sound Experience on InterTalk Radio. Each week, I talk with top professional audio engineers, producers, musicians, and the manufacturers that make the tools that we use in the studio each and every day. From capturing the perfect take to mastering your final release, and the tools and how the pros use them, we are going to dive deep into their process and learn from their experience. I look forward to you joining us each week on Sound Experience with me, your host, Tim Dolbear.
Make this your vinyl night. I'm John J.R. Robinson, and every week, music creation comes alive through stories, experiences, and sounds when vinyl records filled our hearts and minds. My friends and I share our tips and techniques used in creation of iconic tracks for recording artists such as Michael Jackson, Eric Clapton, Quincy Jones, and Steve Winwood, to name a few. Vinyl has emerged hot, and the soul of vinyl defines art and passion, which burns deepest at night. Tune in every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on EntertalkRadio.com.
Todd Zuckerman from the rock band Styx, and you're listening to my pal Jackie Bertone on Jackie's Groove. Groove on, motherfuckers.
Welcome to Jackie's Groove. Come journey with us through the rhythm of the music business with your host, Jackie Bertone.
Everybody, welcome back. And those, and I want to say nylon guitar strings are brought to you by my in-studio guest, my fellow musician and radio mate, Mr. Terry Wollman. Guys, it's Jackie Bertone. Jackie's Groove, brought to you by Talk Radio Network, your connection to all things music. Segment number two. Terry, welcome back, my brother.
Thank you, Jackie.
I just want to follow up real quick. I want to let everybody know that we get a lot of questions about the voice that's on my bumper, and bumper being the professional term of the intro to my radio show. And that is my dear friend, a friend of Terry's for years also, the on-air personality for KTWV 94.7, The Wave here in L.A., by the name of Talia Trigueros. Talia and I go back to 1980. Yeah. I want to qualify on Terry's intro music. Am I going to be saying that is another person? Was it? And forgive me for being, I just sent you a text just now. Is that, am I saying Pat Prescott or is that Carrie Tombazian?
No, it's Pat Prescott. And
so it is Pat.
Also from The Wave, wonderful person, wonderful human being, I had asked her if she would do the voiceover for my show, and she did such a beautiful job, and it's a really fun way to kick off both of our shows.
Absolutely.
Some of the top vocal talents in the radio business. Absolutely. And also dear friends of both of ours.
You know, it's really cool, Terry, also, when you think about it, because I've always dreamed about being in radio. When I was growing up, even as in my adult life, I would cue the music down. I would act like a quasi intro, and then I'd cue the music up. And then this came to me through Intertalk and through WS Radio. Going on 2 years in January, I jumped.
Congratulations!
It took us 2 hours to come up with the name Jackie's Groove, and as they say, the rest is history. And I want to find out from you, brother. You know, when people, is my roster. I'm going on right now 158 episodes. And that's close to 500 hours of me talking. If people know me, I can do 500 hours in talking in 1 hour. Mm-hmm. But the fact of the matter is I love doing that and chopping it up with the he's and she's and even the emerging Monday artists that we've been very successful with. But when I interview people like Lenny Castro and JR and Al DiMeola and Michael McDonald, it's funny because people say, yeah, so what's going on? And like Michael said, well, I just did an interview with Jackie Bertone. And they said, percussionist Jackie? And I said, yeah, he's got a new show. He's got a show, actually, it's a couple years old called Jackie's Groove. Hey, man, I want to be part of it. And it's really tripping me out because I want to find out if Pat, and I mean this as a compliment, is Pat kicking your ass in the way of radio do's and don'ts like Talia does to me on a regular basis?
No.
She's okay. Show off.
Well, she's just been incredibly supportive. But I did get some wonderful feedback from her. I also did from Carrie Tombazian, who was a guest on one of my earlier episodes.
Right.
They've been really helpful, but so have you. I mean, I've always been the kind of person that is not afraid to ask for help.
Right.
I go to people that are the best at what they do.
Sure.
And find out how they did it. And so it's not really looking for approval. It's looking for ways to improve and
exactly
to be the best that I can be. To step up and learn how to do this. I mean, I have a lot of experience from being on television, from working on talk shows. So I understand from being in the room and paying attention what makes a good interview and what doesn't.
Absolutely.
However, it's been a huge learning curve for me, and I'm wondering if it has been for you, Jackie. I mean, I know that you're a natural talker, but there's still, you know, I think you and I both learned really quickly, but mm-hmm. didn't you find that there was a learning curve for you to learn how to be on mic without the assistance of being on camera
sure.
as well?
And I'm still in that right-hand turn, you know, that I haven't come out of that curve yet. And I want to requalify the fact that when I say Talia is kicking my ass, I mean that as a positive. It's not like it used to be. But she would say to me, when you're interviewing a person, a notable, if you will, that's been interviewed umpteen times, when you ask the same question that they've been asked over and over again, don't jump down. Ask the question, sit back and shut up. Even if they're taking their time, they're trying to evaluate how they're going to answer that question they've answered 1,000 times over.
Right.
And it's the way that I ask the question. And I want to qualify, and the listeners out there know, Terry and I have interviewed a couple of the same people, and we probably will continue to do so because Terry's show is completely different than mine. Terry is more, we like to call Terry, how do we say Terry is the James Lipton of InterTalk Radio. He's in depth. He is intelligent. He's inquisitive. As opposed to me, I've got a trucker's mouth and I get something out. I don't particularly want to know, or nor do I care what type of processor or what type of noise gate or what type of things in the studio. I don't ask those questions because I'm not behind the board like Terry is.
Right.
So, you know, and nor do I ask Howard Stern style questions. I don't want to know who you're sleeping with and so on, unless they want to divulge that. So, you know, with that said, you know, and the listeners out there, and not everybody who reads my post or Terry's post is going to click that they like, but I do know there's a lot of famous people out there listening to both of our shows. And so with that said, guys, you know, reach out to both of us, reach out to the network. We will both interview you. I can interview you at 12 and Terry can interview you at 3. It'll be two different interviews. Do you agree with that?
I do. And, you know, for me, I mean, I know we do get a little bit technical on my show, but really the focus of my show, I'm a very curious person and I'm curious Absolutely. About people's creative process. You know, that's what I want to share with my listeners and with our audience so that they can, you know, for me, it's not so much how did you get that break, but what, how did it feel to get that break? What were there any surprises? Was it what you expected? How was it different? How was it everything? Right. Was it everything you thought it would be? Did that lead you directly to the next thing? And how did you maneuver through that? You know, what's your point of view? And also, as you do as well, we don't just talk about music. We talk about life.
And speaking about life, I want to ask you a question. You know my better half. You've known her since you've known me.
Yes.
Caprice. And I've known your better half. Mm-hmm. Much better half, Melanie. Yeah. Much prettier than you are also.
Oh, of course.
Amazing vocalist in her own right. Mm-hmm. But, you know, Cappy, Caprice's nickname for those who don't know is Cappy, C-A-P-P-Y. And she gives me a lot of advice. She also is, she's very critical about things that I do and say. And she corrects me a lot. And I take everything that she has to say, in my heart. And I try not to make that second mistake. She came up with a great question, Terry, and I asked, because I love the question that you ask at the end of every one of your broadcasts.
Right.
The question I ask either at the end or even somewhere towards the end is, if Terry Wollman wasn't playing music, if music was nowhere in your vocabulary or in your vernacular itself, what would Terry Wollman be doing? And Terry, it's an amazing question because people always go, wow, whoa. Mm-hmm. You know, Ray Parker Jr. said to me, I'd probably still be working at the Ford plant with my father if he's still alive.
Right.
Or yeah. I would probably be in jail or probably would have died. Mm-hmm. So let me ask you that question now that I've kind of prefaced that. Answer that question. What would Terry Wollman be doing if he weren't doing music?
I love the question. And it's hard to imagine doing anything but music. However, having grown up on the water in Miami, I think I could be very happy being a water ski instructor at a Club Med, you know, and just having a guitar and writing and practicing and then being out teaching people how to ski and all day. Or I might be that guy. I mean, the reality is I can't do this because I have a spinal cord injury from a bike accident. So I have a titanium plate in my neck. However, I always saw myself as the guy jumping out of the helicopter into the ocean to rescue people. You know, like something that was rescue oriented, you know, helping people, mm-hmm. but doing things that were physically demanding because I've always been physical. So I think I would be, you know, either of those things would suit me quite well.
And I want to thank you personally, Terry. I've said this to you many times on the phone. When I was recovering and still am recovering from my spinal stenosis, right. You know, you were on the phone with me on a weekly basis, and absolutely. I got to thank you from the bottom of my heart. It's because you said there's a lot of things I cannot do, but there's a lot of things I can do, and that's help you through this. And let me tell you something, above and beyond financial help from anybody, just the reassurance that, you know, when you're talking to somebody who kind of went through or is going through the same thing that you did, it was scary. But you know what?
It's came terrifying. Through it.
Your brother yeah. Jackie's walking again.
Right.
I plan not to fall like I did mm-hmm. 5 weeks ago and did a small fracture on my hip. But, you know, it's getting better as we're going.
Right.
And we don't want to take advantage of what we have been blessed with. And friendship is first and foremost. I enjoy hanging out with you and Mel. And I want to get back to the question I wanted to ask you. Has she influenced you? Has she helped you? Has she suggested things that you implement on your interviews?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. And, you know, there are many people who have. There are people that I've grown up with who work in broadcast, who have listened and been kind enough and tactful enough to say, I'm loving your show. It's been fantastic. Are you open to a couple of suggestions? You know, if not, mm-hmm. I'll keep my opinion to myself. And of course I am, because they're people I respect. And you know, they've given me a few pointers about how I can improve hosting, you know, my job
share?
As a host. Yeah, actually, you know, one of the things is when you're not on camera, because you know, a lot of my background has been from performing, you know, music directing late night talk shows. And mm-hmm. so to
go ahead, brag. Let's start with saying Byron Allen, number one.
Well, Byron Allen show for 3 years, then the Late Show on Fox with Jack Mack and the Heart Attack before that. Mm-hmm. And you know, they were incredible experiences, and I was really in my element doing that. But one of the things that they were saying is, and you had mentioned this earlier, to not be afraid of the silence mm-hmm. and to not always interject, because I think it's as an active listener, when you're talking to somebody, it's important to show interest by saying yes or uh-huh or a little, an occasional grunt or nod or things like
right.
that to show that you're engaged. But that's distracting. And I didn't realize that, you know, when you're not looking, but you're only listening, if you're talking and I keep saying, mm-hmm, right, yes,
right,
right, that's great. You know, it's a little jarring. It can be a little jarring, not necessarily, but it was just a point to consider and to not be afraid of the silence. You know, ask the question and sit back and give your guest a moment, like you had said, to just digest and see how they want to approach it, and then be ready, you know, listen and then respond to that. So those are a few of the tips that I've gotten. Of course, Melanie's been extremely invaluable in giving me great, honest feedback. Mm-hmm. So of the producers of our show, you know, Florentino has been great. Paul has been great to talk about what works the best and what might not work as well.
Right.
But you know, when I was, I'm just, again, that gets back to me being a curious person. And I don't know if that applies to you, but when I was working in television, I would look at every show before we did the next show. I would view it and study it. And I would look at what worked, not just for me, but for the band. So I could give good band notes to always make it better. And basically I would look at what worked and say, let's do more of this and less of what doesn't work. Mm-hmm. And, you know,
that's a perfect analogy. Let me just jump in. That's a perfect sure. analogy because, when I do an interview, you know, me, I'm notorious for my 2-hour interviews. In fact, yeah. it was funny. You go, Jackie, are we doing a 2-hour interview? I heard you in your voice saying, cause I'm not going to do 2 hours with you.
Right.
And, but the bottom line is that I learned from the fact, as I tell a lot of the artists, because Terry, at the end of my interview, they will say, my God, we could have gone another 2 hours. And, you know, and that I guess that it shows, you know, props to me that I can carry on a show that way. But when I'm yeah. interviewing, Terry, is that I don't really get a chance to enjoy the interview until I go to bed at night. I pop my headphones in and I go,
right, and take
wow.
a listen.
Yeah, man, like, you know, probably out of all the interviews I've done, I will just say I'm more blessed, and I listened to it just a couple of days ago, is my interview to me, an iconic individual by the name of Al Jarreau, to find right. out that, you know, I was his last interview before his untimely passing in February of this year.
And let's talk about that. You actually, Al, came to your studio and you sat face to face. And
actually came to the house and sat right. in the living room.
Yes.
And, you know, and I have never met Mr. Jarreau or Alan Lopez. I have so many friends. You have so many friends that have been through the band, you know, Larry mm-hmm. Williams, Michael right. Paulo, Tris Imboden. The list goes down the line. But let me just tell you something, Mr. Wollman. If it was the last day I ever had a chance to play music, I sat next to Al. He played vocal bass as he would tap his chest, mm-hmm. and I played vocal percussion.
Right.
And let me just tell you, again, as I say it again, if it was the last time I ever played music, that was it. That was it. And to look
right.
at this man.
I understand that.
Yeah, and just to look at him, as he would say, you know, he's 76 years old. And he walks on stage like an 80-year-old, but this audience loves him so much that they'll wait. They'll have patience.
Right.
Listening to him talk about his longevity and these huge shows at Montreux, he had just gotten back. Mm-hmm. But the fact is, he preferred to stay in a small nightclub and where he can hear the woman in the front row breathing mm-hmm. and where he can lean over and sweat on her husband's blue suede shoes. Mm-hmm. That was a description that was amazing. In fact, I surprised him with Talia, in which... who introduced us and he cried. Then I surprised him with, you know, with Tris, which was incredible. And we're going to talk more about that. This is your life thing that Jackie's done. Jackie will continue to do when it's apropos. And when you said something about constructive criticism, unlike you, who is a think tank, unlike you, who's a lot more diligent than Jackie Bertone is. If you could see my text that I get from Florentino and Paul, Paul will sit there and say, "You're the best shit stirrer that I've ever heard in my life." And then Florentino will send me a message by, "Don't go there."
Right.
And so if you tell me not to do something, guess what? I'm going to do it.
Well,
and
you're a bad
you know,
boy.
And, yeah. Well, I mean, and it's not that way. It's just, I think people want to know that little bit of the shit stirrer out there. But I want to talk to you about the pros and cons. I won't mention any names mm-hmm. About probably one of the worst interviews I had in the history of my 2 years. With one of the most famous players out there in the industry. I won't use the name, I promise you. You know, right. I don't want to police myself on this. See what I did? And I just want to find out if you've experienced that. You know, yeah.
Yeah, we can talk about that when we come back. We've got about 10 seconds left. I want to remind everybody before we go to our next break that I'm going to be performing at the Back Bay Bistro. And if you want to make a reservation, the phone number is 949-999-3121. We will be right back. You're listening to Jackie's Groove.
I love it. Thank you. It's felt so good itself. So we'll be right back, guys, with Terry Wollman.
Hi, this is Tim Dolbear, host of Sound Experience here on Intertalk Radio. And Source Connect by Source Element is the essential tool that we use to link between my studio in Austin, Texas, and the WS radio station in San Diego. Now, with Source Connect, not only can we communicate in real time and with HD audio, but it's synced up and is of a high enough quality that I can use it for real-time ADR work, remote recording and overdubbing, and it even allows me to remotely control a DAW. Source Connect by Source Element, affordable, high-quality audio and video connection over the internet for all of your production needs.
You know what's all around you every waking moment of your life? Marketing. You're choking on it. I'm Scott Robertson, and when it comes to strategic PR, branding, and marketing, I've seen it all. And actually, I'm still seeing it because bad marketing never sleeps. Join me each week on May the Best Brand Win, right here on InnerTalk Radio, and learn how to make the marketing for your brand unforgettable.
Make this your vinyl night. I'm John J.R. Robinson, and every week, music creation comes alive through stories, experiences, and sounds when vinyl records filled our hearts and minds. My friends and I share our tips and techniques used in creation of iconic tracks for recording artists such as Michael Jackson, Eric Clapton, Quincy Jones, and Steve Winwood, to name a few. Vinyl has emerged hot, and the soul of vinyl defines art and passion, which burns deepest at night. Tune in every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on InnerTalkRadio.com.
Are you serious about your music? Are you ready to run with the big dogs? The experts at Pitbull Audio have the gear to get you into the game. From leading manufacturers like Mesa Boogie, Fender, Pioneer, and American Audio, to sound your best, you need the best. Pitbull Audio can deliver in rehearsal, on stage, and into the big time. Dropping beats, shredding guitar, or making the crowd roar. Whatever you dream, Pitbull Audio can help make it happen. We are Pitbull Audio. We want you to play it loud. PitbullAudio.com.
Hi, this is Michael McDonald, and you're listening to my good buddy Jackie Bertone on Jackie's Groove.
Come journey with us through the rhythm of the music business with your host, Jackie Bertone.
Welcome back. I'm Terry Wollman, and you are listening to Jackie's Groove. And Jackie and I are having a conversation today, basically interviewing each other, talking about my upcoming show, but also talking about both of our shows, Making It with Terry Wollman and Jackie's Groove on Enter Talk Radio. Welcome back to your show, Jackie.
Thank you, Terry. Thanks. It felt good, actually, to have it be on autopilot right there. That felt really good. Yeah, I want to say one thing, too. It's really, really cool, guys. When you listen to Terry's music, his bumper music, we said, with Pat Prescott from The Wave, and also the music you're hearing in the background is none other than Terry's own music. Mm-hmm. And then with my music, it is Talia, and it's also, we get more compliments. And Terry, I'm going to blow smoke up Florentino's butt, and along with Paul also. Mm-hmm. We just recently with Ray Parker, Ray stopped us twice and said, "Hey man, who is that music on your bumper music?" He goes, "I'm digging the groove." And then I said, "Well, oddly enough, that's myself on percussion, Paul on guitar, Florentino on drum programming and bass."
So let me just interject for a second. Why would you say oddly enough?
Well,
it should be your music. You're an artist and a writer.
It's so new to me, and it's still so new to me. And and then also too, Al Di Meola asked the same situation. He goes, "Wow, where'd you guys get the budget to hire Carlos Santana?" And to come to find out later on that there's a rift between the two of them. I only know that from numerous conversations with Al. But the fact of the matter is, it's kind of a cool situation. Yes, I do agree with you that it's kind of great to hear that music. In fact, we're thinking about going in the studio and actually turning that into a full song. And we can talk about that later on anyway.
That'd be great.
So let's get back to the crux of this. We talked about this amazing show coming up at the Back Bay Bistro, Newport Dunes in Newport Beach, November the 11th. Doors open at 6, and performance starts at 7:30. Correct me, Terry, if I'm wrong.
That is correct, and we're going to be playing one 90-minute show, full concert.
Give a shout-out to your band, please.
Well, it's a really fun band. I have on piano Ron Walters Jr., who's Barry Manilow's music director. Ron is an incredibly talented piano player and singer. On bass is Andrew Ford, who just got back off the road with Chaka Khan. He is also in Barry Manilow's band. On drums, Johnny Friday, who Tom Scott originally brought Johnny to Los Angeles from Las Vegas, and we have worked together for years, and he's just a wonderful drummer. And guest vocalist Melanie Taylor, who will be singing three songs with us. And I can tell you that one of the songs she's going to be singing is Night in Tunisia. And she wipes the floor with it. It's really great to hear Melanie sing that.
Can I brag for her for a second? Can I just brag on her for 1 second? I always tease you by saying Terry and his wife, Melanie. And Melanie looks at me with a smile on her face. And Terry looks at me like, "Are you crazy?" And so in my opinion, they're married. They'll always be there. What a beautiful couple. But Melanie Taylor, other than being an amazing front girl herself, She is known for her years with Bette Midler, with John Mayer, with the background vocals with a group called Aerosmith and Steven Tyler.
And, she also sang on an Aerosmith record. Yeah.
And with, and of course with, as you just said, the aforementioned Mr. Manilow. Barry Manilow. And yes. I have known Melanie not as long. I mean, I knew her well before you did. Mm-hmm. And when we used to have a band, we used to play in called Talk of the Town. Mm-hmm. And the hardest thing about that in that band, other than Melanie and I, we go back, we said we'd done pretty good in our lifetime after that group. But I'm not being disparaging to that group. But the hardest thing about being in that group was playing cover tunes, number one. And number two, being on the opposite side of the stage of this most beautiful ebony woman that I've ever met in my life. Mm-hmm. And Terry, how you got together with her, my friend, you're dating well out of your league. And I love you for that. but if you guys do yourselves a favor, please go on to Melanie's website. Would I be hard-pressed to say it's MelanieTaylor.com, Terry?
MelanieTaylorMusic.com.
Yeah. And she's got an album out, her most current album, that is absolutely amazing.
It's called The Road I'm On. And by the way, I just came back from a fantastic rehearsal.
Right.
And Melanie is going to be performing tonight, Friday night, at Spaghettini in Seal Beach. So if anybody's listening and is looking for something fun to do, we are performing Melanie's show, The Road I'm On.
Who's the band? Do you want to share?
John Ferraro on drums.
Mm-hmm.
Mark Hugenberger on keyboards. Great Andrew fire. Ford on bass. Myself on guitar. And we also have Melanie singing. We have two guest vocalists. Give me a second so I can look that up. Felice Hernandez and Josie Aiello are going to be singing background. Or front ground, you know, they are artists in their own right. And we might have a couple surprise guests as well.
Yeah, and you guys definitely, you want to get tickets for this event. I don't care, there could be a rock playing on the stage at Spaghettini's. It's a packed house. And then especially with Melanie being there, you guys definitely want to take advantage of your evening tonight. I mean, do yourselves a favor, put the kids away.
Yeah, come on down.
Put the kids to bed and come on out and see the show. And, you know, I want to go back to this for a second here. Let's talk about going back to, because we're really hoping... And we're praying that this series becomes very successful here at the Back Bay Bistro.
Absolutely.
You know, it's got our name on it. And I think I agree 100% with Terry. It's that beauty of pairing music with the food. Because let me tell you, the best times ever talking to friends and family is around a table when you're stuffing your faces. Mm-hmm. That's the quintessential part about Terry being Jewish, me being Italian, Armenian. The best conversations is surrounded by food, family, and friends.
Right.
And that whole situation with Newport Beach, I think it's a no-brainer with Brian Ross helping us out here. You know, if the situation, I love the word Terry used, adult beverages. Mm-hmm. The food is amazing, but come it down is. To Newport early. Spend the day down there and then just and top it off and cap it off by coming to the show. And with, you know, Terry Wollman and his band and special guest stars, Melanie Taylor. Are you excited about this, brother? Are you feeling confident?
Oh, extremely. Both. I'm very excited. Because I love the idea of supporting a new venue that loves music as much as we love food and location. So it's, again, it's got the best elements combined. And I'm also, I'm feeling very confident. I'm looking forward to playing with this incarnation of my band and bringing my music to the South Bay.
Yeah, I Absolutely. Can't wait to come see
it's gonna
you.
It's going to be a fun night, really fun night. And another thing that's going to be fun about it, I know that you are going to be there with your wife, Kathy, celebrating your wedding anniversary.
34 years.
34 years.
Yeah.
I don't even know how that's done.
Yeah, well, it's trust me, she should be sainted by the lack of a better word. And and she, trust me, she has. And what a better way to do it with Terry and Mel. I mean, that's I love you guys. And that's the main thing here. You know, I do want to ask you a question, my brother.
Yeah.
And as I started saying on the last segment, again, I'm glad the CEO is not around right now, so I'm going to go ahead and say it anyways. I talked to you about all the wonderful interviews that we have conducted with friends and, you being more, with everybody that you've known. Me, a lot of people are coming in that I don't know personally, but know of their music. I was introduced to a worldwide superstar that I interviewed last year. Or was it this year? I don't remember. I just want to kind of get it out of my mind. Mm-hmm. It was hell quantified.
Right. Yeah. You ended up in the middle of some crossfire.
Oh, minutia, for the lack of a better word. We're not talking about Stanley let me qualify. It's not Stanley Clark and Aldi Meola. We're talking about another amazing guitar player that was extremely rude to me, or probably couldn't have been rude to anybody, just maybe wasn't me. Mm-hmm. And then after I let him know that I wasn't going to put up with the shit, he became my best friend. And this gentleman only gives 10-minute interviews. I got a half hour out of him. And as he stated to me at the end of the interview, "Wow, Jackie, this has been amazing. I could go another hour." And I said, "So could I, but we're not going to." Mm-hmm. And so with that said, without mentioning names, have you faced a nightmare at all since you've been broadcasting?
No. You know, they've gone, I mean, some have been more challenging than others, but...
That's a good word.
Yeah, but I haven't really experienced anything that's made me uncomfortable. And, you know, I feel very fortunate, you know, that, but, you know, I'm very careful. We are very careful about, you know, choosing the guest, because I want to make sure that they have interesting stories to tell and that they're going to be gracious to our fans and listeners. You know, so that's important to me. So I really have yet to have a bad experience doing this. Some are a little more challenging than others, but really, nothing comes to mind. And I have had people, you know, during my career ask me what my worst musical experience was, or, you know, my nightmare, you know, artist that I've worked with. And it's a question that I never answer. So I would say that if I did have a really bad experience, I certainly wouldn't call it out. Not by name, because I don't believe in doing that.
I dig it.
So it's just something that for me, I prefer to just talk about positive things. I mean, you know, everybody's got their stories of, you know, some kind of thing that happened on tour that there's nothing that can prepare you for that experience.
But it was an experience nonetheless. I mean, it's something you had to get your feet wet in.
Yeah.
You know, it's like telling somebody what steak tastes like if they've been eating peanut butter all their life. We have to draw that photograph.
Absolutely.
And, you know, let's talk about three beautiful women that we've both had. You've had the earlier success with them. I've had the later success with them.
Wilson Phillips. Yeah.
Wilson Phillips. And I'm going to give a shout out to Carney Wilson and to China Phillips and to Wendy Wilson.
Yeah.
Who comprised the group itself. You recently had a chance to hang out with them. I think it was last year in Cerritos.
Yeah.
And when our mutual friend, Troy Dexter invited
you
down.
Troy Dexter, who plays in the band. It was really fun to reunite.
Am I right in saying that their voices are like the quintessential fine wine? They're better now than they were when you were with them in their heyday, for the lack of?
They were pretty amazing when I worked with them at the beginning of their career, but they certainly have the life experience that they have behind them now. Their voices have become stronger and richer, and they sing from a greater depth because they have their own families now and kids, and so they've got more to bring to the table. So, and I think like anything, I mean, they grew up together, so they have a magic. You know, they're almost like three sisters. I mean, two sisters and a best friend, but they've been singing since they were in the crib together. So there's something very unique about working with them. I love all three. You know, Wendy and China and Carney. They're really wonderful people. And you know, it's a part of my musical journey that I'm very proud of, you know, to have had an opportunity to work with them. And just have friends that still play in their band is really a blast for me. By the way, I mean, you play with them too. You know, you've played with them. You've played with the Beach Boys or with Brian Wilson. So, you know, you're kind of ensconced in that family as well. So you know them really well.
Yeah, and I have to ask a question. I know Carney's tuning in because I told Carney, I called her and told her that you and I were doing this. But I also want to give a shout out to Carney's new venture, and that's her baking business.
Yes.
And it's called lovebitesbycarney.com. It's, again, proportional bites of amazing desserts. Do me a favor, please go on and buy some of these amazing desserts. They'll ship them right to your home. So that's my push for Carney. But I have to ask you a question.
And by the way, little aside, you know, people might not know this, but Carney, I hope you don't mind saying this, but Carney has always been very involved and aware in nutrition and exercise. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And as long as I've known her, you know, she's always been a very conscious eater and very focused on being healthy, living a healthy lifestyle.
And I want to just kind of do a thing right here, too. If for those of you who know Carney, and if those of you who know her husband, Rob Bonfiglio, if you're ever in the same room with Carney, Rob, and myself and my wife, you will see Rob in the corner face-palming his hand because his wife has a voice and a mouth that a trucker couldn't even compare with, because that's what I love about this woman. Mm-hmm. And so without getting into stories, was Carney back in her beginning days in the 89, 90, 91, was she as crazy then as she is today?
Absolutely. Yeah. She was shocking. So
that,
she was shockingly. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, well, I got used to it very quickly, but yeah, okay. She just loved shocking people.
Can you see Rob slapping his face with his
Absolutely.
Hand? Okay. So I just wanted
to, I totally get the picture.
I don't even want to talk about a story when we played at Paula Casino and she was asking for an extra guest pass for a friend and she was denied. And when she came up in the suite, I never heard a woman go on a rant that I was so good. But and the answer to the question, yeah, she not only got one pass, she got four extra passes. So with that said, Carney, I love you, sweetheart. Like you have no idea.
I do.
Lola
too.
And Lucy, I love Uncle Jackie, loves you, and Rob. You know, and well, again, you married out of your league, also, as I did. So back to this itself, Terry. I love you, man. I love your music. My favorite album is Bimini. It always has been.
My first album. Yes.
Yeah, you're gonna be hard pressed to trump that music. I have to ask you a question, and I should have asked this is in the last minute and 50. With all the people that you're involved in, let's talk about someone else that you're involved with, is my friend Michael McDonald, who actually sang on your album.
He did.
A song called Our Love.
Yes.
And Michael's new album right now called Wide Open, that was released on September the 15th, is
beautiful,
amazing.
Record.
His voice gets better and better and better.
Yeah.
So with that said, in the last minute, do you have anything that you want to tease the audience other than the performance this coming November the 11th at the Back Bay Bistro? And with the Newport Dunes in Newport Beach. Anything coming up that you want
absolutely.
To share with us?
Absolutely. Go I've ahead. Got a new single that's going to be coming out at the beginning of the year called No Problem, and it's features me on electric guitar. So we rock the house a little bit more than I normally do. And I'm looking forward to sharing that with everybody. Keep your ears tuned on that. I'm also writing for my next record, and I'm working on another movie. Right now I was just in New York, and I'm going back again.
Yes.
This week, producing a song written by Charlie Fox and Paul Williams, and it was pretty remarkable. So we're going back again to do another live version on camera, and I've got lots of interesting things going on.
Congratulations.
And I'll tell you, everybody come on out, and we'll tell you more stories. We play music, and we share stories. It's a complete experience. So
Terry, give me, I'm sorry I'm jumping in here. Give me your quick URLs for everybody to follow you.
Well, the best place to find me is terrywollman.com, TerryWollman.com, and that will lead you to all of my other pages, Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. It all goes there. So that'll keep you current. And also intertalkradio.com/makingit to listen to my weekly show. And of course, listen to Jackie's show every week, Jackie's Group.
Brother, this was fun like you have no idea. Terry, I love you, brother. We will see you
love
in
you
November
too.
The 11th. Get ready to celebrate, guys. Jackie Bertone, Jackie's Group, on TV Inter Talk Radio, connection to all things music. Love you, Terry.
Thank you, Jackie.
Have a great night. And tell Melanie, have a great gig tonight, and we'll talk to you real soon.
We'll do.
This is Jackie Bertone from Jackie's Groove. Come join me weekly on my journey through the music business as I take you behind the velvet rope, interviewing industry notables such as Al DiMeola, Michael McDonald, and Al Jarreau, to name but a few. Listen to their stories on being in the studios recording number one hits and onto the stages throughout the globe. Allow me to be your music historian. You can hear me live every Monday at 2 p.m. and every Wednesday at 12 noon Pacific Standard Time or 24/7 on jackiesgroove.com. Ready to get your groove on?
Hi, this is Tim Dolbear from Eclectica Studios. I'm a full-time mixing and recording engineer. I work with Grammy winners, labels, and indie artists. Using state-of-the-art digital mixing and restoration tools and the very best in analog gear. Really, though, it's my ability to bring tracks to life and fulfill your vision for your music. This has made me sought after by producers and artists worldwide. So spend your time working on music and not chasing a mix down a rabbit hole. Go to timdolbear.com and check out our free one-song mix offer.
You know what's all around you every waking moment of your life? Marketing. You're choking on it. I'm Scott Robertson, and when it comes to strategic PR, branding, and marketing, I've seen it all. And actually, I'm still seeing it because bad marketing never sleeps. Join me each week on May the Best Brand Win, right here on InterTalk Radio, and learn how to make the marketing for your brand unforgettable.
Are you serious about your music? Are you ready to run with the big dogs? The experts at Pitbull Audio have the gear to get you into the game. From leading manufacturers like Mesa Boogie, Fender, Pioneer, and American Audio, to sound your best, you need the best. Pitbull Audio can deliver in rehearsal, on stage, and into the big time. Dropping beats, shredding guitar, or making the crowd roar. Whatever you dream, Pitbull Audio can help make it happen. We are Pitbull Audio. We want you to play it loud. PitbullAudio.com.